Hi everyone, welcome back to Sg Dr Welllness. My name is Dr Chen Yiming. Today I'll be touching upon a group of skin conditions that most of you will be very interested in. Growths on your face. There are many conditions that could result in growths on your face, and many of them may look very much the same. Can you recognize them? How do you get rid of them? Watch part 1 this week and part 2 next week of this 2 video series to learn more about them. And if you're new to our channel, click on the subscribe button now. These are the 7 most common causes of facial skin growth that I see in my practice. Take a look at this picture of the 7 conditions. And I'll be elaborating on them in this 2-part video series. Most of them are benign and are pretty much harmless. The first condition is seborrheic keratosis. These are extremely common lesions. 30% of people have at least one of these by the age of 40, and they affect over 70% of people by the age of 70. They look waxy, and the color may be brown or dark blue or even black. They appear as if it's stuck onto the skin, and some resembles barnacles. And they can vary in size from tiny ones to big ones that are 2 to 3 cm in diameter. There are often no symptoms, though they can be itchy at times. And they are usually found on the scalp, on the face, on the shoulder, chest, abdomen, and back. So, seborrheic keratosis are harmless and often no treatment is necessary. Removal, however, can be done for aesthetic reasons or if it causes problems like itching or irritation when rubbed against clothes or jewelry, or if there are suspicion of skin cancer. Removal methods include cryosurgery, where liquid nitrogen is applied to the growth with a cotton swab or a spray gun, causing the lesion to drop off after a few days. You can also use electrocautery, which I like to use the term electric pen, to remove the growth by burning them away using electrical energy. You could also use laser. Ablative lasers like carbon dioxide or erbium yag lasers can be used to remove them. Take note, however, that seborrheic keratosis are often due to age, and therefore new lesions are prone to occur even after removal. Second, sebaceous hyperplasia. Again, a very common benign skin condition of the oil glands of our skin, involving adults of middle age and older. These growths are often beige or yellowish in color and appear mostly on the forehead, nose, and cheeks. They can also occur on any part of the body except the palms and the soles. Close inspection reveals a central dent representing hair follicle surrounded by yellowish protruding lobules. The cause of it is usually due to aging, but familiar cases have been reported in which younger individuals are affected with multiple lesions, suggesting a genetic predisposition. Also, patients who are on cyclosporine A, which is an immunosuppression drug, seem to have a much higher incidence of sebaceous hyperplasia. Like seborrheic keratosis, they are harmless and no treatment is necessary. They can be removed, however, for cosmetic reasons or if they are bothersome or irritated by clothes and jewelry. The removal methods are very similar to seborrheic keratosis. We can use electrocautery, which is the electrical pen, like I've mentioned above, ablative lasers like CO2 lasers and erbium yag lasers, or in severe cases, even oral isotretinoin can be used. The third type would be skin tags. Skin tags are small, soft, and flesh-colored benign skin growth. They may resemble a soft deflated balloon suspended on a slender stalk. They are probably the single most common bump on an adult's skin. They are harmless, but can be an annoying skin problem as it can get irritated or pulled by clothes or during everyday activities. Almost everyone will develop a skin tag at some time of their lives, but middle-aged obese adults are more prone to having it. Occasionally, some of the smaller skin tags may drop off on its own. Removal often is not necessary and it can be done for cosmetic reasons or if they become a source of irritation or discomfort, such as when it's pressing against the bed when sleeping or when it constantly gets irritated during movement, such as if it was growing under your armpit or your groin area. Treatment involves cutting it off with a surgical knife or scissors, burning it off with electrocautery or ablative lasers, strangulation with a ligature. Right? We have come to the end of the first video about growths on our face. Thanks for watching till the end. Click on the subscribe and like button if it was beneficial to you. Please remember to tune in next week for part 2 of the series, where I will be talking about viral warts, moles, milia seeds, and syringoma. Till the next time, stay safe and stay healthy.